Hello, I've been doing a lot of work with these 250 size quads lately with Arduino and NRF24 modules and multi-way and telemetry and things like that. But the more I try and put on here, like I have this little camera and FPV thing, and I probably want to put a GPS on the back here at some stage as well. But there's not much room on these small quads, so it's sort of getting, pretty short for space as I progress. And in particular, these new propellers that I got recently are going to be a problem because there's just nowhere to put them. I mean, you can see what I mean, right? That's not going to work at all. So unfortunately, I had no choice but to upgrade the frame and the motors and the ESCs and all of this. And so, yeah, it couldn't be helped, but unfortunately, I had to make another quadcopter build. So, this is what we have to accommodate these new propellers, you see. That's why I had to do that. So, this is a so-called X525 frames, just aluminium beam arms. Pretty cheap. You can get this for less than $20 from most places. I don't know why it's called a 525 because it's actually 600 millimeters in size. But it's fairly light, fairly simple, and it should give me more room to put stuff on here at least. And I like this particular style because it can be folded to carry on your back or in your hand a lot easier as you're riding your bicycle to the river. So I haven't done anything wacky with Arduinos or NRF24 modules on this one so far. I just wanted to get used to flying a larger quadcopter, and since they're a little bit more dangerous, I thought it would be prudent to just go with the regular kind of receiver transmitter system. So what we have on here, that's just a regular orange RX receiver, and that's talking through a PPM connection to the CC3D board, which is just under here. And the only other thing that's inside there is a bunch of wires for the ESC power and the controls for the speed controls. That's about it. So there's nothing really interesting about this build, I'm afraid. This is a kind of a neat little bracket thing that I found, though. That's quite pleased with that. Actually, you just drill a couple of holes somewhere and stick that bracket over the XT60 plug, and it's on there really solid. So it doesn't flap around, and you can just put your battery on here, and there's a nice little no excessive wires hanging around. But anyway, this video, there's nothing really interesting about programming or Arduinos to show you. I just thought I'd give you a look at the maiden flight video of this because I had a bit of trouble with the tuning. This is the most trouble I've ever had with tuning for a quadcopter so far. I've barely had to change anything for the other ones. And it's just sort of jittering like this constantly. And I know my way around PID tuning fairly well because with the stuff that I did with Box 2D, I spent hours and hours changing the PIDs for those things. And it's a lot easier to see how the PIDs are working when you can change something and immediately see the results, as you can when you're doing it in software with a 2D simulator like that. So I know what to do to get the PIDs working, but no matter what I did, it just didn't really seem to give me a smooth hover at any point. So I'm not really sure what the issue could be. I'm just sort of wondering if anybody watching this video would have any clever hints. So my possible theories might be that the ESCs are a bit funny. The radio connection I'm thinking should be okay, but of course the well, I said I wasn't using Arduino, but I am actually using the Arduino inside here. So what I have in here is the Pro Mini, and that's just taking the inputs from the joysticks, and it's creating a PPM signal for the Orange RX DIY transmitter inside there. So I guess there's potentially some issue with the PPM signal coming to the transmitter. That could be one problem. Or it could just be that it's too light. It is quite light, and it's very, very floaty to fly. But I don't think that should be an issue. And if that was the problem, it should be able to fix that by tuning the PIDs nicely. But, yeah, anyway, so long story short, I haven't quite figured out what the issue is. I'll load it up with some more weight next time and see if it'll make any difference. But for now, I'll just show you the video that I got today. All right, let's see if this works. Oh, I'm kind of nervous. PIDs are very badly out of tune. It's very floaty, like when you let off the throttle, it doesn't really go down much, not quickly at least. It's I like the sound of it, it's nice and quiet. Anyway, I'll fly a little more. Well, I've played around with the PID settings a lot. I don't think I can get it a whole lot better, but I'm just starting to wonder if one of these ESCs, or more than one of these ESCs, is kind of screwed up, because I can hold it in a nice steady hover, so it's hovering, you know, moving a little bit like this, and then all of a sudden it'll go boop like that, or boop, and then it'll recover just briefly. I'll see if I can get it to do it here.
didn't. Didn't really do it there. Not quite the same as it did last time. I'm just wondering, it might also just be the wind. It's not really that windy, but this is very light. It's, I think we're just a touch over 800 grams. And there's a fair bit of surface area when the props are spinning, the 10-inch props, so I don't know. But that's the last battery I have today to try PID tuning with, so we're going to have to come back another day and spend a bit more time trying to get it smoother, I think. Anyway, thanks for watching. See you next time.